Yagi's parents instilled in her the need for a useful, quote, useful education because of their concern for monetary stability, a result of their internment during World War II. But Yagi obtained her MBA and she worked for 27 years in finance. But she left corporate life behind for good in 2008 and has since then has been a full-time artist. So let's give a round of applause for you, Sam.
So yokai have pretty much been replaced by scientific knowledge that we have now. The neat thing is yokai are still really ingrained in contemporary Japanese culture. And the other interesting thing for me is growing up in Denver, I was very detached from Japanese culture and understanding my heritage. I learned just a ton about Japanese culture from studying this size. And the stories behind them are just incredible. The interesting thing is I think yokai culture came over with the immigration to the United States. I remember my grandmother and mom talking about yokai around the dinner table, about flames coming out of graves and foxes turning into women and so on. So it's just a very fascinating aspect of mythology. Next slide. And this last one is called the Hakutaku, and it's an extremely wise beast that's both in Chinese and Japanese culture. And these are only appear when there's a wise and benevolent leader. So this is part of the next series I'm doing for a show at the Art Gallery, which is cryptids, monsters, and also incorporating Sailor. So anyway, that's
thank you, Sandy. Can we just